Hey, YouTube. How's it going? Oh, hey, you know what? Give me this camera. What it is, YouTube. We're here in the Obat Theater again. We've got AFK person one, AFK person two, chat moderator. Hey, Sis, what's up?
Hello.
Hey. Delco, who's AFK as well. We got Al. What's up, Al? How's it going? Hey, Al. Say hi to YouTube. Good enough. Hey, Soundwave. Wait a second. Didn't I just see you in the YouTube chat? Oh man. The Back to the Rec Center event is starting now. Do you guys think I should go? All right, I'm gonna set the camera up here in the corner. I should probably set it up in the corner. All right. And here from stream camera. There we go. All right, YouTube. You guys can hear me, right? I hope you can hear me. Please tell me you can hear me. Oh, you can hear me in the chat? Okay, cool. Here, I can barely hear you because my ears are this camera right now and the voice roll-off in this room is a little low. So. Hold on, I'm going to try to read your lips. I have no idea what you're saying, but it's okay.
Hi, Sean. Hi, Mom. Dad.
All right.
You think I'm joking?
Hey. All right, cool. All right. Just hang tight while we get everything ready, and we'll be in the theater shortly. Thanks for your patience.
Hey, Ryan. Glad you can make it. Sandwave, welcome back. Keep that cat at bay this time. Oh, that's right. Oh, okay. Adorable wolves. Okay.
Yeah, the audio may be weird here in
Yeah, you made it.
In the lobby. Just a heads up. I do mute all of the players who are not actors for the sake of your viewing pleasure, YouTube. So you'll only probably be able to hear pigeons. So it'll sound like he's talking to himself, which is great.
No, that's also very weird. We don't want to make cakes out of alpacas. I'll just stop now.
Oh gosh, I need to readjust that. That looks weird. I'll be right back.
Oh no! You. All right. In order to atone, you need to come here. You have.
Might need to tell some folks to not use place-based mover during the production.
Everyone, if you are currently in a party, please go into your watch and leave the party, because I will be adding everyone to a special party that will be able to, the people who are signed up will be added to a party to get taken into the next room. And so I don't want to be bringing in people who are not part of that group.
Hello, Carthage.
Hello.
That was a super fast invite. Holy shit.
No, I was already here.
I know.
It's a negative time invite. You went. The invite went back in time and invited him.
Hey, this right. way, if he exactly. crashes, he'll get an invite immediately.
Right. Yeah, that's how it works.
Right? I'm just thinking ahead here. Yes, I'm going to get over 200. That's my.
You can turn them off. You just need to be watching your notifications whenever you're in your room.
No, that was not on stream. Why?
If you leave them off, it just means your watch doesn't buzz. You still get them.
Thank you.
everyone's in there.
Okay. We're by ourselves over here. Do you wanna hop through?
Yeah, if you don't mind, just one more, yeah. Hello. Oh. Thank you. Thank you for the reminder. Hi, stream. Carthage and I are going to hop to a different room super quick to do something that has no bearing on this event.
Is there no photo in this one?
No, we that's for the Princess Bride, but we didn't have time to create a proper Princess Bride poster yet.
Gotcha.
It's a reserved spot for the Princess Bride show.
I see.
I need this event, Orange Bucket Theater, private, and here we go. Yes, and invite party. Here we go.
Oh, fuck, really? What? I'm having pigeons.
Oof. Jesse! I crashed the dorm immediately. Like
I noticed.
Hey, Jesse. Hey, we want to do a small after party. So if you guys want to stick around.
Yes, Eric.
Hey.
It feels like the cold shoulder that he just runs away from you, but then I realize that you guys are just like
I stream.
In the room, so.
I don't know if Geary can hear me. Hi, stream. Hello. It's gonna be a good show. They always are. How many times have we done this now?
Five.
Holy crap. That's a lot of shows. Oh, okay. Oh, so Geary's just silent. Well,
there we
he's
go.
Talking
now,
anyway.
Now my audio is working. Yeah.
There
I was about
he
to
is.
Offer to be your interpreter.
Oh, yeah. Delco. He knows how to do VR sign language.
All right, I have sent out the first round of party invites. If you got it, please check your notifications to make sure you got one.
So I'll be
everyone should have,
my point of
everyone
view
who got
on my
one should
channel.
Have a green wristband.
Oh, yeah.
later.
Yeah, check out Emily's channel in a few days.
If you did not get a party invite, don't despair. We still have some open spots, but we're waiting for a few more people to show up. If they don't, I will be sending out invites to pretty much everyone else that's in the room currently.
Watch me get the thing again. Where it's me. I don't know why.
You're Gribbly's favorite record player. That's why.
No, it's him. Delco.
Oh, I guess I was on.
Yeah.
I guess that's why you didn't talk to me when I talked to you.
I guess that's why. It's okay.
Can you see?
I had to do it to him.
You don't see it.
No, I don't.
Really?
It's making it weird. Yeah. There's no floor over here.
Anywhere over here?
No, anywhere over there. The floor ends right here for me. And then there's no more.
Can you teleport onto it? Try going to your dorm and coming back.
I'm hoping when we go to the theater, it'll be normal.
I'm sure it will be.
Alright, stream. Looks like we're gonna get going in a few
minutes. Alright, everyone.
Hey, there it is.
Everyone should currently have a green wristband.
Yep.
In a few minutes, we're gonna be, and actually here in about 1 minute, I'm gonna be moving everyone to the next room. So you'll probably get a message saying, you know, do you want to follow? If you get that message, click yes. If you don't get that message and all of a sudden you get teleported out, you're being taken to the next room. Don't worry about it. In the words of one Mario, here we go.
I do wonder why it's always Emily. It's kind of weird.
Telling y'all, it's because Emily's Gribbly's favorite rec room player.
You know what I wonder if it is, Emily? I wonder if it's because you have the lowest overall player ID in the room.
Oh my god, that'd be so interesting.
That's probably
does
it.
She, though? Does Delco?
Yeah. Yeah, no, mine's...
Delco's might be lower than yours. Early.
No, it's not. It's not.
Okay.
No, it's not. Emily's.
I bet you anything that's what's going on. That's why it's not picking the person who went to the door, who actually operated the door and triggered it. It's going to the lowest player ID, which is...
Listen to these guys talking about nerd stuff.
That's a real weird way to do it, but I can't prove that it's not true, so...
It's always Emily, though. Every time
some
we jump in
from
Act 1 to Act 2 or from that room, it's always Emily.
It really is, yeah.
I have
all right.
Welcome.
Get
and actually, Joker...
Here.
Now that I think about it, the only time it wasn't Emily was during the dev show. It was Votivator.
I see your mouth moving.
Wait, my mouth.
Votivator's more than likely an earlier account info.
Yeah,
Votivator was probably playing his own game before Emily.
Yeah.
I'm surprised
that's my point, though.
I think he's actually in double digits.
Votivator is.
That's my point, though. That's what I'm saying is. That's the point I'm trying to make, though. It's like the only time.
Wait, Drummer, do you mean Darth Votivator from Cyberjunk City?
Tiger, that's so confusing.
Hang on.
Spoilers.
We can't hear Delco.
Generally,
I
like,
can't hear Delco at all.
In and then up the stairs to the side.
Yeah, he's having issues.
I see his mouth moving.
There's also, like, pretty good
I see his mouth moving, but I don't hear him.
I see his mouth moving, but I can't hear him. Is the speaker on? Do you have the speaker turned on right now? No? That's weird.
Go in the Discord, Delco.
We don't
can.
Walking sounds...
You can't hear anything.
Might be a rec room bug. You might need to restart.
Yeah.
That's rec room sign language for restart.
What is?
Bad.
Yeah, okay.
There's too much side fumbling happening here.
No, you won't have to mute yourselves. Please don't interrupt, but we encourage you to laugh and do good reactions.
The only rule is... Yeah. As you can see, there's a wall here. That's
the rule. There's a wall there.
The rule is walls.
Shut up, Emily.
Walls are rules.
It's spray bottle.
But what I'm saying is there are walls
and
here all around.
Come here so I can spray bottle you
with
the camera.
Do not try to clip through them.
What?
You clip through a wall, I will, especially if I see you trying to clip through the walls. If it's accidental, that's one thing. But if you're purposely doing it, then I will not only kick you from the room, but I will ban you from this room.
He'll do it, too.
He'll
do it.
So, I will. We have plenty of people have interest. My attitude is on it that if you are wanting to come in and disrupt, I would much rather give your seat to someone who...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then you can't. Then you're not invited to his birthday party, too, and that's, you know...
Nope, you get no Christmas cards from me.
Drummer throws rad parties, so...
Better?
Oh, by the way, audience, I can't hear any of you. I'm just letting you guys know that now. That's just for the audience on stream to be able to enjoy the show without, you know.
And I hear you talking.
Hearing you guys.
Also sounds good.
Drummer. Well, you're not drummer. You sound good, sir.
What? When did the lights turn off? Other one came out and it scared me that it was dark.
That's not something you want to see in the darkness, I tell you.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, Emily. How's it going?
Hi.
All right, stream. We're about to start, so I'm going to mute my own mic so that you guys can enjoy yourselves.
I'm just going
to
stand here.
Without hearing my gross voice.
I don't know. Hi, everyone.
Yeah.
Delco had to restart as well, so it might be the same thing.
Yeah. Yep.
We had some audio issues yesterday in the other room.
Okay, bye.
See you soon, Jess.
Wait, what the?
What?
Fly up with me.
Where the popcorn is? It's gonna be thrown at pigeons.
By the way, that reminds me, one other thing. We don't really mention this in the announcement, so I'm just gonna say now. Please do not spawn in food or anything else during the play. The sound effects of that is really loud and it's regardless of where you're sitting, everyone will hear it at full volume. And it can be really distracting.
Like moving around, jumping. Yeah. So just kind of try and stay in one spot. That means us too.
You want to turn all that
in the
up.
Green room area.
You want all your volume sliders maxed out.
The audio is still going to warp and distort.
Oh yeah, it will.
Yeah,
that
okay.
always
yeah,
happens.
It
is. That's
There's
not,
nothing
we can do
about
that. Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing we can do about it.
Music.
Just like halfway through the
curtain. No, it doesn't.
Oh, you were.
It's like you're playing it from a really, really
warped record.
Yeah. It's
or
set in the sun.
Record player with the belt is slipping.
I'm thinking warped tape.
Yeah.
I'm like stretched out tape.
Yeah, that's what it is.
I have no idea what it sounds like. It's like the healthy mood situation, but with my music.
Sometimes it does get that bad, where it does sound like I'm using a voice changer when I'm not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're gonna do.
It's part of the announcement. Yeah.
Sometimes the room
but yeah, you can turn
off
names right now. And also make sure your volume sliders are all the way up.
Hey, pigeons.
We
have a Just Me voice.
I'm back over. I'm going back over to the lobby real quick. There's at least one person in there who signed up to be one of the first ones in there, and we have the space, and they're in there. So I'm gonna go grab anyone that's remaining, then come back and we can get started.
Yep.
Yay! I think so. Yay.
Joker.
Yay!
Yep.
Good.
You good to do your intro?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Excellent.
I was just waiting on Jasmine. Just let me know, and I can do it at any time. I'm not really feeling like timing the presentation is as important as it was with the
Earthbender. People from the lobby.
Yep.
Sound testing.
Huh?
Hey, Eric.
Can you hear me?
Stick around after the play.
Yeah.
We're doing a small after party.
I could also hear you.
Yeah, there's an after party.
Oh,
by the way, I want to point out, there is a lower level. Literally no one is on the lower level, so if...
That's a great space to
feel
watch.
Free to start to move down.
I always, actually, I always sit.
Yeah, if you want the whole room to yourself, go to the lower level.
Yeah, that's where I am. That's where I sit.
Nobody goes there anymore, it's too crowded.
Yeah.
Romeo, head upstairs to the seats. We're in there, that's fine too. All right, I'm back.
Ah, yes.
It's terrifying,
you
but
are
sure.
Technically. it is now.
Does that make him a butthead?
Romeo, please head up to either upstairs, here
to
the seats.
Oh, did I say that?
I'm
sorry. Stop trying to kill me with the popcorn. It worked yesterday. It won't work here.
Is this tradition at this point?
It is.
We're good.
Do you realize how much effort it takes to clean this theater?
Yep.
Yeah, none.
And you're lucky about that. Because you're making a huge mess.
I don't care what you're worried about, Chris.
Hey, Lily.
All right.
Nice to see you here.
I'm ready in a
time. Thanks for attending.
Yep. All right. You guys ready?
Yee.
Shall we get this road on the show?
All right. Let's show
everyone,
the road.
Please take your seats if you have not already.
All right. Thank you. I'm gonna head out there. And off the stage. Hi there. My name is Joker, and before we introduce the production, I have a preface for some of our audience, especially those of you joining us on YouTube. Orange Bucket Acting Troupe are players and community members of Rec Room, and Back to the Rec Center is, in part, a love letter to the Rec Room community, as was our production of The Princess Bride 2 years ago. As such, we want to acknowledge that some of you folks may not be familiar with some of the common references in this production, but we want to assure you that there's plenty to enjoy. You might not be familiar with Alkmaar, our dear friend, questing buddy, and Rec Room staff member, who has a reputation for firm but fair conduct moderation. You might not be familiar with Gribbly, creative director and founding member of Rec Room, or Votivator, a friendly person and skilled software developer. We acknowledge that you might miss references to Frontier Island, or to Camp Lone Pine, one of our creepiest attractions, or to the various game glitches and exploits from over the years which have captured our imagination. But that's okay, because you will become familiar with people like Emily Waffles Yay and Delco, who are here with us tonight as part of our crew. And yet, more broadly, we assure you that this production was crafted in its most basic elements of love and good spirits, and that thus it has universal appeal to all good-natured people, no matter where you come from in virtual space. And now, please welcome I Kill Pigeons to the stage to give a proper introduction to tonight's production.
I fell off the stage too. I mean, welcome,
Bucketheads.
One second. Hey, Biff. If you keep interrupting, I'm going to tell Alkmaar that you were being disruptive.
Whatever. I'm not scared of her.
Keep telling yourself that. Just get to the green room.
Fine, whatever.
All right. Let's try that again. I
didn't fall off the stage this time. It's already going better. Mm. Welcome to the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe's latest production. This play lasts about an hour and a half and takes place in two rooms. Thus, there will be one room transition. Everyone should be moved to the second room automatically as long as they're party up. However, we will give a notice that's about to happen in order to avoid an unexpected and jarring experience. We don't want everyone thinking they crashed to their dorm. However, it doesn't always work, so it very well might be one person with a notification in their watch to go to the next room. So check your watch when it's time. In the second room, please return to your viewing spot in a timely manner, and the play will resume when everyone is settled. Please remain in your viewing spot and do your best not to disrupt the experience for your fellow audience members. This includes not making unnecessary noise. If there's a possibility for background noise, you should mute your mic or set it to push to talk. We do want to hear your play-related reactions, but we don't want to hear disruptive noises or your mom yelling at you. There are invisible walls in front of the viewing area. Do not attempt to get through them. Please try not to move around if possible. We have no way of turning off walking or teleporting sounds, and thus moving around a lot can be loud and disruptive to your fellow audience members. If you have to move, try to do it when the curtain is down. Disruptive people will be kicked and might be banned from future Obot productions. There is currently a bug with some of the audio in Rec Room that might cause it to distort or sound odd. There's nothing we can do about it on our end, so please bear with us. Also, please be patient with us in the event of any other unexpected technical issues, though hopefully Biff stays off stage when he's supposed to be off stage. I'm sure some of you might be wondering why we created such a unique theater design. It's meant to get the audience as close as possible to the action because LODs made a normal theater experience prohibitive. Please set your volume sliders to full, or you will not hear a lot of the sounds and music we use in this play. We hide names, but due to room performance, they don't always stay hidden. Thus, for immersion reasons, we do recommend you hide names until after the show. After the show is finished, we will give backstage access to those of you who want to see behind the curtains and chat with the crew. Without further ado, the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe is proud to present Back to the Rec Center.
Jennifer, check out the truck invention in the merch booth. One day, Jennifer, one day I'll have enough tokens to buy that. Think about it. We could drive around Frontier Island Resort in style, camping at Bucket Lake, under the stars, all alone. No one to bother us.
I like that. Ranger Royce says Frontier Island's really romantic and peaceful.
Speaking of Bucket Lake, are we still going tomorrow?
Yeah, absolutely. George is in the car.
Save the go-kart! Save the go-kart! 3 years ago, a video of a go-kart success in Rec Room was uploaded to YouTube. A few days later, Coach announced an update. I know in my heart it was the update that was supposed to include go-karts. Save the go-karts!
What? They already gave us the ability to make our own vehicles. Give it a rest.
But a Rec Room original go-karts track would be so much better. Will you not upvote my canny post to save the go-karts?
Alright, Watts. Alright, I'll upvote your post, but no more talking about go-karts during AMAs.
Okay. Thank you, kind sir. Here, take a copy of this flyer. Share it wherever you can.
Sure, whatever. Now get out of here.
Save the go-karts! Save the go-karts!
Where were we?
Right about... it's my dad. I gotta go.
Oh, I'll message you tonight.
I'm playing on my alt account here. Let me write it down.
You're listening to Rec Center Radio KREQ.
Get wrecked.
And now, the news.
Doc,
officials
at Medicorp
have denied the rumor that the shipment of missing Rectonium was in fact stolen from Cyberjunk City 2 weeks ago. A group of lumberjack paintballers had claimed responsibility for the alleged theft. However, Medicorp now attributes the discrepancy to a simple clerical error. Rec Room Support, who were investigating the matter, had no comment.
Hey, Doc, where you at?
Marty! Marty! Ah, Marty, there you are! Now, don't touch this invention! It's unstable and might cause you to crash!
Yeah, thanks for the warning. So did you want to meet with me just to show off yet another one of your unstable inventions?
No, I need your help with a different invention! Meet me at Camp Twin Pines tonight at 9 PM Rec Room Standard Time, and bring a holotar camera!
Sure thing, Doc. I'll be there. Oh, perfect. Just perfect. Shut up.
I can't believe you lent me your car without telling me it had blind spots. I could have been killed.
No, Biff. I never noticed any blind spots when I drove it. Hi, Marty.
Are you blind? They're there. How else do you explain what happened?
Biff, can I assume that you're gonna replace my car with your tokens?
My tokens? It's your car. You should pay to replace it. I want to know how I'm going to get the new A-Rank trophy gear. All the other speedrunners are blocking me. Hacking your car into the game was the only way I could complete it. How am I supposed to get the blue archer hat now? And where's my whiteboard art?
I haven't finished drawing it yet, but I figured since the contest deadline isn't until
Hello? Hello? Anybody home, huh? Think, McFly, think! I gotta have time to save it as my own invention. Do you realize what would happen if the devs found out I was cheating the contest? I'd get banned. You wouldn't want that to happen, would you? Would you?
No! No, of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen. I'll finish those drawings up tonight and hand them over first thing tomorrow, alright?
Alright, well, not too early. I plan on playing laser tag and reporting any teleporters I see. Why don't they just learn to use the walking locomotion? I never needed teleport. Hey, McFly, your shoe's untied. Don't be so gullible, McFly. We don't even have feet. I can't believe this. I get your car towed all the way back home, and you don't even have any root beer for me. What are you looking at, Buckethead?
I know what you're gonna say, my friend, and you're right. You're right. But Biff just happens to be on the laser tag leaderboard, and I'm not very good at confrontations.
But the car, George, he totaled it. It's got a giant boulder in the side. He needed that car tomorrow. Jennifer and I were going to take that to the lake together. Do you have any idea how important that is to me? Any clue?
I know, and all I can say is, I'm sorry.
We'll have to eat this ourselves. I had to ban Carthage for impersonating a dev. Again.
Ooh, pizza. That almost makes up for the lack of root beer.
Marty, instead of going to Bucket Lake tomorrow, why don't you and Jennifer create a minigame event instead? That's how George and I met.
I thought you guys met playing Golden Trophy.
Well, we did. I saw him in the rec center. Except it was called the locker room back then. He looked so lost and nerdy in those suspenders that I took pity on him and invited him to play with me. While we played, he told me about a minigame he created.
I remember this story. He was such a noob at Quest that you felt sorry for him and decided to attend his event called Murder Mystery.
No, it was a murder mystery game called Coach's Dinner Party. It was my first minigame. I'll never forget it. It inspired me to create Minigame Mondays.
Yeah, those Minigame Monday videos, those were what got me to start playing Rec Room. They were really good. If not for those, I mean, I would have never met you, George, or Doc Brown.
Thanks, Marty. You're a good friend.
Oh, yeah. I have to meet Doc for something. I'll see you later.
Invention. This is the big one, the one I've been waiting for since I started playing Rec Room. Look!
A DeLorean go-kart?
Bear with me, Marty. All your questions will be answered. Start the holotype recording, and we'll proceed. Good evening. I am Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing at Camp Twin Pines. It's Saturday evening, October 26, 2020, at 9 p.m., 9:18 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time. This is Temporal Experiment Number 1. Now, please note, the DeLorean's clock is in precise time with my watch. Got it.
Right. Check, Doc.
Now, if my calculations are correct, when this thing hits 8.7 meters per second, you're gonna see some serious shit. Yes! What did I say? 8.7 meters per second! We did it!
You disintegrated the DeLorean.
No, Marty. The DeLorean is perfectly fine.
Where is it?
Not where is it? When is it? I've just sent it into the future. Precisely 1 minute into the future, to be exact.
Wait, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine into a DeLorean?
Well, the way I see it, the Cybertruck's not available yet, so this would have to do. Oh, watch out! Ah. destination time on this keypad here. Here's a red letter date in the history of Rec Room Science. March 5th, 2017. Yes, of course. March 5th, 2017.
I don't get it. What happened on that date?
That was the day I invented time travel. I remember it vividly. I was in the locker room, using the chair glitch to climb up to the ceiling, when I fell and hit my head on the basketball hoop. When I came to, I had a vision in my head, a picture of the flux capacitor, which is what makes time travel possible.
Flux capacitor?
Yes. It's taken almost 3 years and most of my tokens to realize the vision of that day. My coach, has it been that long? Things have certainly changed around here. This camp used to be owned by Ranger Roy. He had this crazy idea about breeding pine trees. He kept trying to invite people here to camp, but no one would because of rumors that it's haunted. He eventually moved to Frontier Island instead.
This is heavy, Doc. This is great. Does it run on normal gizmos?
Oh, unfortunately, no. It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity they require.
Doc, you don't just walk over to the merch booth and buy rectonium. Did you rip that off?
Oh, well, of course. From a group of lumberjack paintballers. They wanted me to build them a power weapon, so I took their rectonium. Then I put a laser pistol inside a leaf blower and told them that was a power weapon. Here, put on some S-Rank quest gear. It'll protect you from the rectonium's radiation. We have to load the time machine. Here we go. That goes in there. All right. Put that away. Now, start recording again. I, Dr. Emmett Brown, are about to embark on a historic journey. Oh, wait a second, what was I thinking? I almost forgot to bring extra rectonium. Oh, how did I expect to get back? One pellet, one trip. I must be out of my mind. Oh, my coach, they found me. I don't know how, but they found me.
Who? Who?
Who do you think? The lumberjacks. Oh, run for it, buddy. I'll draw their fire.
No! Bastards!
Get him!
Please keep up with this!
What?
Oh. Oh.
What?
Oh, man.
Who are you? A hacker? You're moving without teleport.
No, I'm not cheating. Sorry about your tent.
This is the last straw. I'm sick of you kids trashing my campground. Stay right there. What? My pine! You killed my pine, you hacking son of a witch!
This can't be happening. It's a nightmare. Wait, there's a public lounge? Hey, HeathyMoose, what's today's date?
Today is March 5th.
Yeah, what year?
2017, duh. Hey, outfit, what day?
Thanks, it's from a quest.
Yeah, you. Did you just come from a paintball game or something?
What?
What's with that outfit that's all painted neon?
Oh, I'm looking for somebody. Doc Brown? Would you happen to be friends with him?
Nope. Sorry.
Can you check your recent people list? Because maybe he was in here.
Listen, are you going to order something, or...?
Yeah, give me over here.
Beer? You want beer? Play Sports Bar VR. And here, we pour water.
Hey, McFly! What do you think you're doing?
Biff?
Hey, I'm talking to you, noob! Did you email AG support and tell them that you falsely reported me the other day?
I figured it could wait till Monday, since I'm hosting another Kosher Dinner Party minigame this weekend.
Hello? Hello? Anybody home, huh? Think, McFly, think. If I get too many reports on my account, I'll get banned. You wouldn't want that, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen.
What are you looking at, Buckethead?
Hey, Biff, check out this guy's quest armor. He must be afraid of the dark. Put nightlights on it. What a dog.
So about that email, McFly?
Okay, Biff. I'll tell AG support tonight that I falsely reported you so that you can play tomorrow without worrying about getting another ban.
Well, you better. I plan on spawn camping noobs in paintball tomorrow. Hey, McFly, your shoes are untied. Don't be so gullible, McFly. We don't even have feet. Hey, I don't want you hosting any more coaches' dinner parties. Your last mini game was a disaster. Everyone left after I showed up.
What?
You're George McFly.
Thanks, Emily. Yeah? Who are you?
Hey. What do you let those boys just push you around like that for?
Well, they're a higher level than me.
Stand tall, buddy. Have some respect for yourself. Don't you know, if you let people walk all over you now, they'll be walking all over you the rest of your life. Look at me. You think I'm gonna spend the rest of my days in this flophouse? Not me. I'm gonna learn how to organize PvP tournaments, and one day I'm gonna do something great for the record community.
Oh, that's right. He's gonna start a paintball league.
Yeah, I'm gonna... A paintball league. Now that's a good idea. I should start a paintball league.
A paintball league, that'll be the day.
You wait and see. I will start a paintball league. It'll have the best paintballers in Rec Room competing against one another.
Good! You can start by going to paintball and leaving my customers alone!
Paintball league. I like the sound of that.
George! Hey, George, wait up!
You there! Do you want to play Golden Trophy with me? It's too tough for me to beat by myself. Oh, wow! I've never seen an outfit like that before. Where's it from?
It's from Quest, he said so. It must be some sort of special S-rank reward.
Oh, wow! You must be pretty good at Quest, Marty.
Huh? Oh, yeah, I've played it a lot. Oh, Lorraine! Do you know Doc Brown? I need to find him.
My recent list says he's in... Shield Soccer?
actually play shield soccer.
It's gotta be a bug. He's probably in paintball or 3D charades.
Thanks.
I'll send you a friend request. We should play Quest together soon.
Doc?
Oh, quiet! Don't say a word! I don't want to know anything about you!
Doc, it's me, Marty. You gotta help.
Quiet! I am going to read your thoughts. Terribly sorry. Wrong bucket. Here we go. This is the one. You put this on your head. Won't hurt, I promise. I'm going to read your thoughts. Yes. You have come from a great distance.
Yeah, exactly.
Excellent. All right, next bit. Subscriptions. You want me to buy a subscription to Rec Room Magazine?
No.
Okay, don't tell me. Don't tell me. Donations. You want me to make a donation to the Adjective Animal Sanctuary?
Doc, I'm from the future. I came here in a time machine that you invented, and now I need your help to get back to the year 2020.
But I haven't invented any time machine.
Doc, look, I'll prove it. Look at my level. I'm level 42. Everyone else is still capped at level 20. I still have features from the future. I can change my clothes without going to my dorm room. See? I can change from teleport to walking locomotion. And I can summon a camera with my hands by going like this.
Oh, you can you? Those others are pretty mediocre tricks. You're probably just using some play-space mover to wander around like that, and some other hack to change your clothes and your level number. I'm not convinced.
I'm telling the truth, Doc. You gotta believe me.
Oh, okay then, future boy. Tell me this. Who is the community manager in 2020?
Mama Monkey.
Mama Monkey? The dodgeballer? And who's on the support team? Delco, I suppose? You're probably tell me Harry Manlegs runs the YouTube channel or something. Ugh. I've had enough of these practical jokes for one evening. Good night, future boy.
No, wait, Doc. Oh, the bruise on your head. I know how it happened. You told me the whole story. You were using the chair lights to climb to the roof of the locker room, and then you fell off a chair and hit your head on the basketball hoop. And that's when you came up with the idea for the flux capacitor, which is what makes time travel possible.
My coach!
And that's why I need your help getting back to the future. Hey, Doc, why is your lab in shield soccer? Isn't that dangerous? Anyone can come in here since it's a public room.
Oh, no. It's the safest place to experiment with my exploits and hacks because nobody ever plays shield soccer. Look, my latest invention, the double shot bow. Give it a try. That's odd. I swear that thing worked yesterday. Well, never mind. Show me this time machine you're talking about.
Yeah, but let me pull it out. I have it saved in my watch as an invention.
But you could save things in your watch? Fascinating. Oh, wow, look at this. This is incredible. Ah, it works. I finally invent something that works.
You bet your ass it works. I have a holotar recording you should see. Here.
Oh, Ah, this is interesting. I bet I could connect this up to the scoreboard projector here. Let me see.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown.
Hey, look. It's me. Twin Thank flies. Coach, I still have my hair.
October 2020.
What is that outfit I'm wearing, though? That's what you had on when you first got here.
This is temporal experiment.
Oh, yeah, that's S-Rank Quest gear to protect against radiation.
Oh, of course, of course. From the fallout of all the Goblin Wars. Oh, this is truly amazing. A portable hologram recorder.
This
Unfortunately,
is the part
no. It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I needed a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity they require.
Wait, the what? Play it again, play it again.
No. It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity they require.
21 gigawatts? 1.21 gigawatts? Oh, great Scott!
What the hell is a gigawatt?
Gigawatts? Oh, how could I be so careless? 1.21 gigawatts? Oh, how am I going to generate that kind of power? It just can't be done. Oh.
Doc, look, all we need is a little rectonium.
Oh, a little rectonium, you say? Ah, well, I'm sure in 2020, a little rectonium is available in 2-star boxes as a treat, but in 2017, it's a little hard to come by. I'm afraid you're stuck here, Marty.
Whoa, stuck here? I can't be stuck here. I got a life in 2020. I got a girl. She's crazy about me. Look. She wrote, I love you, on the back of this poster board. It says it all.
Mm. I'm afraid that's not enough, Marty. The only power source capable of generating 1.21 gigawatts of electricity is an announcement from Coach. The power of love is just not enough.
Wait, what did you say?
I said the power of love. It's just not enough.
Yeah,
we need
right
an announcement
that.
From Coach. Unfortunately, you never know when one will happen.
Look, we do now.
Oh, yes, this is it. This is the answer. It says here an announcement from Coach is going to happen at approximately 5.04 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time next Friday. Wait, an update on a Friday?
Yeah, well, the devs learn not to do that in the future.
Hmm. If we could somehow harness the power of this announcement, channel it into the flux capacitor. Yes, it just might work. Next Friday evening, we're sending you back to the future.
Yeah, Friday's good. I can hang out in 2017 for a week. I mean, you could show me around. We could do some questing, attend some minigames.
Out of the question! You must not leave this room! You must not see or talk to anybody! You must not have any fun! Anything you do could have serious repercussions on future events! Do you understand? Make sure you use teleport instead of that walking locomotion as well, so you don't get banned!
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Marty. Have you interacted with anybody else besides me today?
Yeah, I sort of bumped into a couple of friends that I know in the future.
Oh, great Scott! Change your clothes again!
I can't.
Yes, as I thought. Marty, how did you find out about Rec Room in the first place?
I saw some Minigame Monday videos my friend Lorraine made and wanted to check out the game.
Yes, this fits with my theory. Yeah, just as I thought, your camera gesture, first that didn't work, and now you can't change your clothes outside your dorm room.
But the saved outfits button's gone, like, it's been erased.
Erased from existence! Doom, doom, doom! Lorraine won't convince George to host another coach's dinner party. And because she doesn't attend it, she won't start hosting Minigame Mondays. You won't see the videos, which means you're going to keep losing features from your future account because you won't have ever started playing Rec Room in the first place. And unless you repair the damage, your entire account might disappear. It would be like your Rec Room character never existed at all.
This is heavy, Doc.
Oh, now is not the time for lifting weights, Marty. Get that here.
Oh, that's George over there. Hey, hey, George. Remember me? We met in the public lounge earlier.
Oh, yeah. I remember you.
Good, good. You know that girl, Lorraine? She told me that she really wants you to host another coach's dinner party so she can attend.
Really?
Oh, yeah. All you gotta do is go over there and tell her you're hosting a murder mystery event and invite her.
What? Commit to hosting an event right now? What if she doesn't want to attend? What if no one shows up? Even worse, what if Biff shows up and ruins it again? I don't think I can take that kind of rejection. Besides, I think she'd rather go play with somebody else.
Who?
Come on, Lorraine. Let's go play disc golf, just you and me. It'll be fun.
Leave me alone, Biff. I don't want to play with you.
Maybe you do and you just don't know it yet.
Get out of my face.
Hey, you heard her. Get away from her.
Yeah, what's it to you? Are you just looking for a fight? Oh. Hey, Alkmaar. Just showing the new guy around Rec Room. Look, you're new here, so I'm gonna cut you some slack. So why don't you make like a tree and get out of here?
George, hey, you gotta host that event.
There's no point. Biff is just gonna ruin it again. There's no Rec Room player that can convince me to host another event.
No Rec Room player. Huh. Hello, player!
Who are you? How are you in my dorm?
I am Darth Motivator, a Rec Room dev from Cyberjunk City.
Marty! Wait, Marty! I need your help! I just posted on Reddit that I'm hosting another kosher dinner party. I need to invite Lorraine, but I'm too nervous to do it.
Alright, okay, listen. Keep your shirt on. She's over in the lounge.
Okay.
What made you change your mind, George?
A few minutes ago, Darth Motivator from Cyberjunk City came to my dorm and told me that if I didn't host another murder mystery minigame and get Lorraine to attend, he'd ban me so hard it'd melt my VR headset.
Yeah, well, let's just keep the headset melting to ourselves, okay?
Okay.
There she is, George. All you have to do is go over there and invite her.
Okay, but I don't know what to say.
Tell her Destiny brought you to her. Tell her she's the most talented Quest player you've ever seen. People like that stuff.
Destiny? What? I've never played that game.
No, George. Oh, Destiny is in... It was meant to be. Tell her she's destined to go to your event. I'll tell you if something to ask.
Marty! I was hoping you'd get on. There's this crazy ice skating bug today that lets you glide around. I tried it, but I got sick.
Yeah, that sounds neat. Hey, my friend has something to say to you. Go. Do it. Go. Okay.
Lorraine! Destiny has brought me to you.
What?
What I meant to say was...
Wait a minute, don't I know you from somewhere?
Yes, I'm George. George McFly.
I know, your name is above your head, same as everybody else's.
Oh, right. I'm hosting a murder mystery minigame tomorrow. It's your density to attend. I mean, it's your destiny.
Oh.
Hey, McFly! I just saw your post saying you're hosting another minigame. I thought I told you I didn't want you hosting any more of those. Alright, that's it. I'm reporting you.
Wait, Biff. Is that a dev in the audience?
No, I just see a lot of bucket heads. Wait, he's using the ice skating bug! After him!
I don't even know how he's doing that!
Hold down both grip buttons and lean backwards! Get back here! Slow down! Get over here! My parents are gonna be so mad. They just put new carpet down in our VR space.
Who is he? What games does he play?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find out.
They found me! I don't know how, but they found me! Run for it, Bonnie!
Doc?
Oh, Marty! I didn't hear you come in! Fascinating device, this holotar recorder of yours!
Hey, listen, Doc. There's something I haven't told you about the night we recorded that holotar.
Please, Marty! Don't tell me! No man should know too much about his own destiny! I mean destiny!
You don't understand.
I do understand. If I know too much about my own future, it could endanger my Rec Room account, just as you have endangered yours.
You're right.
Now, let me show you my plan to send you home. I am outfitting the DeLorean with a microphone attachment, you see, so that we can harness the power of the coach announcement. The announcement speaker in the locker room. Now, the way it works is
You will start over from the other side of the locker room, right over near ping pong tables, driving directly towards the announcement speaker, accelerating to 8.7 meters per second. Now, according to the flyer, at precisely 5.04 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time, Coach will make the announcement just as the microphone passes the speaker, thereby sending 1.21 gigawatts into the flux capacitor and sending you back to the year 2020.
Are you sure this will work, Doc?
Oh, no, not really, but it's worth a shot, don't you think? Anyway, you take care of your friends, and I'll take care of this. By the way, what happened today? Did George invite Lorraine to the coach's dinner party?
I think so.
You think so? Well, what did she say? Oh, it's her! Quick, we've gotta hide the secret plans. No one can know. Space-time hangs in the balance.
Hi, Marty!
Lorraine, hi. How'd you know I was in here?
I followed you.
Oh, this is my doc. I mean, my friend Doc Brown.
Marty, this may seem kind of forward of me, but I was wondering if you'd like to play Quest together on Friday night? Just the two of us in a private game?
Wow, you mean, like, nobody's invited you to do anything already Friday?
No, not yet.
What about Coach's murder mystery event, Coach's dinner party?
Oh, well, I mean, George seems nice and all, but I think a person should be confident and strong-willed and stand up to bullies and protect their friends, don't you?
Yeah.
All right, we are going to move to Act Two shortly. Hopefully, and make sure you have your green wristband, by the way. Thanks, Kay.
That was beautiful.
And
yes.
Someone has an invite. Emily, accept her invite. Let's go. I'm gonna wait and make sure.
All right, bucketheads, return to your seats.
What? Leave and come back.
Yeah, do you want to leave it and I'll invite you back?
Is anyone else having that problem?
Yeah, it looks fine for me.
Yeah,
if you can't, anyone's
seen through the room, just leave and
having visual bugs. Yeah. Okay.
All right, bucketheads, hurry up and get to your seats.
Once again, to reiterate, we had some people join in just now. If you have any visual bugs, let us know and leave, and we'll re-invite.
Good? Okay.
Seems like we're okay. Welcome back. You had your notifications on this time. I like Kay's outfit, by the way, the glow-in-the-dark skeleton outfit, because when we're on stage, everything's dark in the audience, and there's just a skeleton there. It's just floating. It's pretty great. I don't even, like, I have no words. I'm just going to take a picture. it must be a glitch. Yeah.
Don't question it. It's fine.
Yeah. This game is perfect. It has no bugs, right, Carthage?
Mm-hmm. You're a glitch.
Shut up, Biff. All right. Everyone looks settled. Let's turn the house lights off, and we will resume. Oops.
But I don't understand. How is she going to be at Coach's dinner party if she's going to be playing Quest with you instead?
Because she wants to go to Coach's dinner party, she just doesn't know it yet. That's why we gotta show her that you, George McFly, are a fighter. That you can stand up to bullies and be confident enough to run a murder mystery event worth attending.
Yeah, but I've never picked a fight in my entire life.
Oh, you're not gonna be picking a fight. You're gonna be coming to her rescue, right? Let's go over the plan again. At 4 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time, where are you going to be?
I'm going to be in my dorm.
Right. Where am I going to be?
You're going to be in the locker room with Lorraine.
Right. So then about 4:15, she's going to get very angry with you because people usually get upset when they get bucketed.
Whoa, you mean you're going to put the orange bucket on her head?
Relax, it's just an act, right? Okay, so like 4:15, you stroll into the locker room and you see me about to bucket her. You come up to us and you say, you're lying, George.
Hey, you, get your damn bucket off her. Do you really think I ought to swear?
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Coach, damn it, George, swear. Okay, so you come up, you vote kick me, I get vote kicked to my dorm, and then you and Lorraine go have fun at Coach's dinner party.
You make it sound so easy. I just wish I wasn't so scared.
There's nothing to be scared of. You just need a high five to give you confidence.
Can I have another one?
Yeah. Hey, do you mind if we just hang out in here for a little while?
Sure, socializing in the locker room is always nice. You seem nervous. I won't friendly fire you when we play Quest together, I promise.
Lorraine, have you ever been in a situation where you know you had to act a certain way, but then when you got there, you didn't know if you could go through with it?
You mean like how you're supposed to act during a Q&A?
Well, sort of.
I know exactly what you mean.
You do?
Sure. I just don't think about it and ask the devs when boxing will be released.
Hey, I spent all day cleaning my carpet because of you. I'm gonna vote kick you every time I see you. You all better vote yes on the vote kick I just started.
F, leave him alone.
Oh, what do we have here?
Ah! No! Stop! Get it off me! No! Ah!
Hey!
Stop!
You! Get your damn bucket off her! Oh.
I think you've got the wrong locker room, McFly. Just turn around and head back to your dorm.
George, help me, please! Ah! Stop! Ah!
What? Are you deaf, McFly? I said scram!
George, please! No! Ah! No. Oh, stop!
No, Biff! You leave her alone!
Okay, George. Whatever.
Biff, stop bullying him! Ah! Stop! No! Ah!
That's it, Biff. I'm...
What's it, huh? What?
I'm reporting you for harassment.
What? No one in here is going to vote to kick me.
He just reported him.
Hey, guys, come on. Guys, it's just a joke. Come on. They're friends, so don't think yet.
Wow.
Are you okay? Let's go to Coach's dinner party together.
There would be music.
There's no music. There's...
I'm
leaving.
So, how do we play this coach's dinner party game? Also, didn't you say there would be a DJ?
Oh, yeah. There's a DJ over there. I'm sure he'll start playing music anytime. In the meantime, I'll explain the rules. Everyone gather around.
Marvin. Gotta start playing some music.
Sorry, man. My voice meter is busted. I can't play music through the boombox.
Marvin, look. You gotta play. This is she plays Murder Mystery for the very first time and gets the idea for Minigame Mondays. If there's no music, people won't stick around and play the minigame. She won't host her own version, and then she won't post Minigame Monday videos, and then my account is history.
I mean, look, the dinner party's over. Unless you know somebody that can DJ. Oh, come on.
I'm a rec center DJ. Give me the boombox, I got this.
A rec center what? You know what? You're the DJ. Play something that really cooks.
Alright. Something that really cooks.
Hey, Gribbly, it's your favorite rec room player. What? No, not Delco. Come on. Anyway, you know that new intro music you've been looking for? Well, listen to this.
Hey, George. I heard you reported Biff. Good job, man.
Thanks.
Marty, I hope you don't mind, but I asked George if I could host my own coach dinner party on Monday, so I won't be able to play Quest with you then.
Great. Good. Good, Lorraine. I have a feeling about you hosting minigames.
I've got a feeling, too.
Hey, listen, I gotta go. It's been educational.
Marty, I want to thank you for all your good advice. I'll never forget.
I'm happy to help. Well, good luck, you guys. Oh, and one other thing. If Rec Room releases a sequel to Golden Trophy, and one of your friends accidentally goes too far ahead and aggroes the whole bell tower full of goblins, wiping the entire party right before the boss, go easy on him.
Of course, that sounds like a really easy mistake to make, right, Lorraine?
Where is that kid? Damn. Where is he? Ah! Marty, there you are! You're late! Have you no concept of time? You're a time traveler, for coach's sake! Come on!
Come on, the locker room is full. I had to wait for someone to leave before I could join. You know, it's crazy. Oh, Doc. Sorry, guys. 1 minute.
Oops.
I can't.
Sorry, you two are having some technical difficulties.
Yeah, so we just had
another minor technical glitch.
We just had Biff, DDoS, and crash three of our actors. So please bear with us.
I did no such thing. If they just need to fix their game, Dennis.
You're not Biff. Wait a minute. Are you ban evading?
No, would I do that?
Yeah.
No, see,
yeah,
it's
me. We just lost three actors that are in the scene. So, please
Please bear with us. We just lost three actors. They're coming back. Is that a butterfly with a head on, like, an upside down butter? Okay, that's weird. And there's a skeleton nightlight over there. Biff, I thought I reported you. What are you doing?
I have a higher reputation than you do. I have nothing to worry about.
Well, at least I didn't spend all day cleaning my carpet. Yeah, well... Okay, so it sounds like Star Waffles, yay, do have internet, and they'll be back shortly, so please bear with us. And Dr. Emmett Brown, you know, his inventions are very unstable. He accidentally
It's all right. I'm back now. I've returned. I don't know what Marty did to the time.
How did you
talk? He caused me to cease to exist.
What was that? What is this music? Huh. It's kind of catchy. Makes me want to dance. Come on, dance with me! Yeah.
This is much more catchy.
That's it, Biff.
You're not doing anything. You're gonna do what? What was that? What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna focus.
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Help!
See, look, I told you he's a buckethead.
I can climb out of this, I think.
Nope.
I ascend.
I don't even know how he's doing that. Vassini, how do I fly like that? I want to chase him. Vassini, where are you? I need some help. He flew away.
Just hold down your jump button to fly.
Hold down my jump button.
It is so hard to find good help these days. I'm going back to paddle ball.
Doc, did you make the router for them? You know your inventions are very unstable.
I already told Marty when he first appeared. Be careful of that invention. It's unstable and might cause you to crash. I had that in a vision of what would happen.
Yeah, well, Marty
future.
Isn't the one who crashed. Why didn't you tell Emily and Star not to mess with it, huh?
Yeah, you should have told Star Waffles.
Would be breaking into my dorm room and messing with my inventions. Marty is the only one on my friends list who has access.
Oof. Right.
Probably copyrighted. Whoops. It's probably copyrighted.
Yeah, does anyone have a... You know what? I can fill in for Star in his one part. If needed. Well, his next part, if needed.
Remember, George, you're talking in game and in Discord.
I know. I
so
know.
Everyone hears what you're saying, but not here. They're not hearing Joker.
I'm hearing Joker, but I'm not. My Discord is
muted.
But no, it's fine. I don't care. At this point, I don't care if they hear us talking about the outage. They understand.
Oh, so you're saying that you don't care about our audience? You're confusing
We're having technical difficulties.
This is
Surprise!
Why your ban report didn't work.
I didn't even report you, Biff. I just told AG support that I did it on an alt. They're coming back soon. In the meantime, hey stream, you wanna play patty cake?
They have internet again, so they're coming back.
I haven't played patty cake since like last week, so I forgot a little bit about it. Sorry. Right.
No, we can't. We need Emily.
Uh, apparently we just learned that we need Emily for this play. It'll just be a minute for her to come back. Apparently she's kind of important to, you know, to the roles. And thank you all for your
just
patience.
Just a bit. Hell of a lot more important than you.
Well, I mean, to be honest, we could just do this scene without her and it would be much simpler. You know, nothing could go wrong.
But it wouldn't be nearly as entertaining. I love watching you guys fail. Oh, we got Star.
We have a Star Waffle.
We have the less important one. Now we need the really important one.
No, Biff, the least important person, you, has been here the whole time.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know you've been here. I said they're less important than Emily.
Oh, okay. Your voice is normal. HeathyMoose is fine. Don't worry about it. Everyone, we're going to start that scene from the top. So.
The worst time.
Thank you for your patience.
I'm going to murder Henry today. That's what's going to happen.
HeathyMoose, no murdering. Murdering is bad, HeathyMoose.
Says who? That was horrible. Okay, let's go.
Oh, where is that kid? Damn. Marty, there you are. Oh, have you no concept of time? You're incredibly late. What's been going on?
None at all. Well, the locker room was full, and then everybody started dropping out of the game. But yeah, George really came through. Yeah, George was able to vote kick and report Biff. I didn't know he had it in him. I mean, he's never stood up to Biff like that before.
Never? Oh, this could have disastrous consequences for this timeline. That's probably why people started dropping from the game. Oh, the damage you've done, Marty. This is terrible. If we get you back to the future quickly enough, maybe we can undo this mess. All right, now I'm going to set the DeLorean to send you back to the exact time that you left. Hopefully none of this will have happened then. Now, you will go way over there by the ping pong table. That's where you'll start from. Take into account the precise distance needed for you to be moving 8.7 meters per second at the instant you're passing this announcement speaker. When coach rings, coach doesn't ring the bell. When coach announces the update, I ring the bell. And that's when you hit the gas. Got it?
Right. Thanks, Doc.
Thank you. Okay. See you in a few years then. Yes.
I hope so.
Don't worry. As long as you pass that speaker with the microphone attachment precisely 8.7 meters per second, the instant coach makes an announcement, everything will be fine. Nothing could possibly go wrong.
Right.
Wait, What is the meaning of this email you have sent me entitled, Don't Open for 3 Years?
You'll find out in 3 years.
Oh, it's information about the future, isn't it? I warned you about this, kid. The consequences could be disastrous.
It's a risk you're gonna have to take. Your life depends on it.
Oh, I've already disappeared from the timeline once. Oh, how much worse could it be? No, I'm not taking the chance. I won't accept the responsibility. I'm gonna mark it as spam.
You know what? In that case, I'll tell you straight out.
Hey! Hey! What happens when I put a dart in a fridge?
What are you doing, child? We're in the middle of a very important... What? No! Oh no! No! Ah! Ouch!
HeathyMoose, what have you done?
Oh, you've ruined everything! Oh, and you hit me in the head! Oh, I'll rattle the bruise from before! Ouch! All right, Marty. We have to get you back to the future. We really need to repair the timeline. Things are becoming terrible. You get in the car. I'll try and fix this up. You know, continue the plan as before. All right.
Damn it. Why'd you have to put that email in the spam folder? If only I had more time.
Wait a minute, I have all the time I need. I have a time machine. I can just go back 10 minutes early and warn it.
Alright, this is where it needs to go. Just like that. And, ah! That's no good. Can I just hold it? No, I can't quite reach from here. Oh, no, that's not it. Oh, it's not time yet, Manny. Don't come. That was an accident. You there, Healthy Moose. Come down here this instant. This is all your fault. Come down here right now.
Okay, I'm coming.
All right, Healthy Moose, it's clear that you're underage. You're a very small child. I can tell. Now, I can report you for being underage and you'd be gone. You would never play this game again. The alternative is you help me fix this mess that you've created. Okay. Are you up for the challenge? Can you do it? All right, now, you see this bell here? It's a very important bell.
I love that bell. Yeah, I love it. So, what I do is I come to the locker room, and then I stare at the bell, and then I hit it, and then I get happy. Isn't that a great story?
That's a wonderful story. Excellent, Healthy Moose. I'm very glad to hear that you know how to operate a simple bell. That's good.
You just hit it. Now, have you ever done it before? Clearly.
Yes, but in this case, it's very important that we hit it at just the right time. So I'm going to need you to get in the booth there.
No,
not yet. Get in the booth and stare at the bell, just like you do in your story. Right? You're very good at this, I'm sure. Stare at the bell. You will get to hit it, I promise you, but not yet. Just wait.
Why can't I just hit it?
There's no time to explain. This is a very delicate operation and we're already short on time. Now just get ready to hit that bell when I tell you to. Alright, we're almost there. No, not yet. 57, 58, 59, now, hit it now. Today's the time.
Attention, a new update is available. Please quit Tech Room and download the update.
Oh, yes, we did it. Oh, huge success. Oh, Happy News, make a note here. Huge success. Yes, that was the intended effect. That's what we wanted to do. We sent the annoying child back into the future. He can no longer ruin the timeline for us. Oh, this is wonderful.
The new rec center. Oh, this is beautiful. Everything's beautiful. Wait, the color seems off though. Oh, but look at the merch booth. Oh, it looks great. The lumberjacks.
What? Hey, look. Okay, look, using inventions to hack things into the rec center is not okay, okay? I'm giving you a 10-minute timeout.
No, wait, I can explain.
How did he do this? I have no idea.
Let's see who keep up with this. Doc, no! No! You're alive!
Hey, Marty.
A paintball shield? How'd you know? I never got a chance to tell you.
Ah, I recovered that email from my spam folder, you see.
But what about all the talk about the screwing up the future events, the space-time continuum?
Well, I figured you'd done so much damage already, I'd already ceased to exist once. What could possibly be worse than that?
Yeah, I guess. So, how far ahead are you going?
Oh, I figure about 3 years. It's a nice triangular number.
Yeah, well, look me up when you get there, all right? I guess I'll probably be about level 47.
Yeah, right. I mean, yes, you got it, buddy.
Hey, take care. Oh, and watch that re-entry. It's a little laggy.
Thank you, buddy. I will.
I think we need a rematch, George.
A rematch? Why? Were you cheating?
No.
Hello.
Good morning.
George, Lorraine. Oh man, you guys look great. Lorraine, that dress is fantastic.
Why, thank you, Marty. Oh, I almost forgot. Jennifer was asking about you. Isn't tonight the night of the big date?
Wait, what?
Aren't you two going to the lake tonight? You've been talking about it for 2 weeks.
Lorraine, we already talked about this. The car's wrecked.
Wrecked?
Wrecked? When did this happen?
Now hang on. I'm sure the car is fine. See, here's Biff waxing it right now. Now Biff, I want to make sure we get 2 coats of wax this time, not just one.
Just finishing up the second coat now, Mr. McFly.
No, Biff. Don't con me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fly. I meant that was just starting on the second coat.
Ah, Biff. What a character. Always trying to get away with something. You know, I've had to keep an eye on Biff since even before the PSVR beta. Although, if it wasn't for him...
We never would have created all of our awesome mini-games for the community.
That's right.
Hey, George, Lorraine, I just saw the craziest thing. Some guy dressed just like me. Oh, hey, Marty!
Carthage? I thought you were banned.
Banned? Marty, what are you talking about? Why would I be banned? I work for Rec Room.
Hey, George! George! The art contest result just got announced. You won!
Yeah!
Hey, congrats, George.
Thanks,
oh,
Carthage.
Oh, hey, Marty. Also, I meant to tell you, your new truck's parked outside the kitchen. I got it all waxed up and ready for the weekend.
Truck?
Yeah, I said, parked outside the kitchen.
He heard you the first time, Beth.
Then why did he ask?
Oh, hey, man. Minister. How about a ride?
Jennifer. Oh, are you a sight for sore eyes? Let me look at you.
Marty, you're acting like you haven't seen me in a week.
I haven't.
What's going on? Are you feeling okay?
Oh yeah, everything's great.
Marty, what's going on?
Marty! Marty! You've got to come back with me!
Doc?
Go back.
You've got to come back with me, Marty! Back to the future!
What?
Come on! No time to explain, quick!
What are you doing, Doc?
I need fuel!
What?
Come on, quick! Get in the car! We've got to go!
No! Don't go, Marty!
No! I just got here, okay? Jennifer's here. We're gonna take my new truck for a spin.
No, bring her along. We have to go in this. The truck's not capable of time travel. Come on.
Oh, Why? What happens to us in the future? Do we become mirror dwellers or something?
No. You two turn out just fine. It's your little brother and her younger sister. They get your accounts banned by association. Come on, we've got to stop them.
Hey, Doc, you're going to need to back up. We don't have enough stage to reach 8.7 meters per second.
Stage? We don't need stage.
Where are we? When are we?
We're in the year 2023!
You really weren't kidding about time travel, were you?
That's right, I said we'd go 3 years in the future and here we are in 2023! Now, Marty, Jennifer, your siblings and Beth's younger brother Brith should be here any minute now. Whatever happens, you need to stop your siblings from agreeing to play with Griff. Remember, don't let them know that you're related to them. Or it may break the space-time continuum!
Got it. Don't break space-time.
Space-time? What?
Yeah.
Just don't tell them that you're related. It's very important.
Hey, you two, let's party up and go, team up and rep rail solos.
We should go to squads instead.
But they just announced season two, and I want the Bear Keeper outfit before anyone else. Cheating's the only way I can do that. Come on!
Cheating is wrong, though! What if we do it? What if we get caught?
What's the matter, HeathyMoose? Chicken?
Don't call me chicken! My name is HeathyMoose, you got it right the first time!
But well, maybe party up! Come on!
Hey, you
could
kids!
Probably.
Don't cheat. Go play squads if you want to team up.
You're right, mister. Let's go team up and go play squads.
Yeah.
Bye, Griff.
Thanks a lot, Bucketheads! How am I supposed to get the Bear Air Keeper outfit now?
You know, Griff, you sound pretty young. What are you, 7?
I'm not 7. I'm 11, and I'm gonna report you all for being heads.
not if we report you first for being underage!
You can't do that!
Yes, apparently we can. We just did that.
disaster averted, so... What do we do now?
I'm not sure. That was a lot easier than I thought it would be.
We could play that cowboy quest.
I don't really feel like going to the Wild West right now.
Hey, Doc, you once said the future is whatever you make it, so make it a good one.
Well said, Marty. Yes. How about Jumbotron 2.0, then? I hear they have rec sabers, yes!
Now that's a good idea.
Let's go!
It's only going to take 3 years. Thank you. We hope you all enjoyed the show. And apologies for the technical difficulties. Thank you again for all your patience. We would like to give a huge thank you to the Rec Room developers for allowing us to use their sounds and music, as well as creating this wonderful game and the UGC tools used to perform this play. We would also like to thank the band I Fight Dragons for giving us permission to use their version of the song Power of Love. And now to introduce the cast and crew. I Kill Pigeons as George McFly.
Buckethead.
I also co-directed and wrote the script. Eric as Marty. Yeah. Jessmy as
Jennifer and Lorraine's friend. Princess Fuzzy as Dr. Emmett Brown. Other knights, Carthage, but not tonight. And Biff's goon, Carthage. Oops, I mean Fezzik, not Carthage. A bit of a mix-up there. Yes, that Fezzik. And Carthage is a goon, though. Let's be honest. Mama Monkey as herself. As Lorraine. Not herself. As Lorraine. Right. Yes. Yes. Drummer Geek as Biff and Griff. You can boo those guys.
Boo.
It's okay.
Shut up, Buckethead.
Drummer Geek also was the theater, set, and circuit designer and helped direct. Everything in this theater was created by him, with exception of the few rec room props we used. He's been amazing with this. Centurion as Watts, a lumberjack paintballer, Ranger Roy, Zhang Yi, Marvin, and Marty's younger brother. Emily Waffles Yay as literally herself, as well as a lumberjack paintballer. Emily the bartender. Alkbar. Super intimidating. And what is easily, let's be honest, the best character in the show. Big applause for HeathyMoose.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm scared of Alkmaar.
And now, the two gentlemen that you did not see on stage but are integral to this performance. Delco, the sound technician.
Oh, he was in the bucket the whole time.
Wow. He was in the bucket the whole time.
He knew it.
And Joker, the control board operator.
There he is.
Joker.
Now, for tonight's show, we have had a special guest appearance tonight. Give it up for Carthage playing himself.
Together. Yeah, band and everything to be in here.
Yeah, he went through so many band appeals to be able to perform tonight.
There you are. Bring it for Dev impersonations.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them. Thanks.
Oh, no, there's three. All
right.
Oh, gosh, three.
They're multiplying.
I got to finish this up before we all become Carthage. But seriously, together, we are the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe. Shut up, Biff. Together, we are the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe. Thank you. And now we are going to open up the backstage for anyone that wants to come back and see behind the curtains.
Bear with me.
Or chat with us. If you go back to the room that you entered at, there is doors on either side that say cast or crew only. If you go through those doors, you should be able to go through those doors, and you can come backstage if you want to see what it's like back there.
They can. I unlocked it.
Ooh.
Excellent. All right. Ooh. Come on back, guys.
All right.
I'm going to stand up for this one. What'd you all think of this show?
Welcome to Thank you for the cheers. Storage.
Guys, let me trip over a chair first. Hold on. I got to put this camera down.
All right. Yes, I didn't crash this time.
All right. I'm doing the show. Are we doing
only
the
Doc yes. and we Star Waffles crashed.
Oh, wait, hold on. Here, it was...
I wonder what's going on back here. There might be some sort of special guest appearance by somebody or something. Wow, look at all these props. Who are you?
It's
Healthy Moose.
I'm sorry,
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm
sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I think you know, because you know.
Oh, cool. All right. Yeah, let's do it. All right. Welcome to Behind the Scenes with Healthy Moose. All right. Let's see what's going on.
Our Wi-Fi keeps going down. Our Ethernet doesn't.
So there's like this really good
Yeah. I did, but I did turn it on.
Oh,
HeathyMoose, your watch is floating in front of you there. You gotta get rid of that.
Your thing is floating in front of you.
Oh, okay, I see.
Anyway, that's how the curtain goes.
Be careful
with that thing.
Okay, I can do that.
It's
a lie.
It's supposed to blow.
That's dangerous.
This is mine. Don't touch it.
It's not 2017. Oh, where'd you go?
It's gone now. Hold on. Where am I?
All I can see is that the...
HeathyMoose, where did you go?
Look at that! Look all the way back there!
I hope you like the show! Thanks for coming!
Yeah, I see! Where are we going?
Let's go back and see the stages.
HeathyMoose, don't forget about the ride! Don't forget about the ride!
I'm getting there, and I'm probably this is the party that I left!
Yeah!
I'm your director, HeathyMoose! Well, that explains why she doesn't read from the script at all.
Because it's on the stage, and then this is your time.
Oh, you should be careful. There's some radioactive stuff. Yeah.
Yes, be careful. Everybody stay away from the Reptonium if you're not wearing this request gear. It could be very dangerous for you. Please stay back for your own safety.
Yeah!
I warned you.
This never gets boring.
Consequences could be disastrous.
Right.
This is the whole point of this tour.
Just so you can come back here and push the bell, huh?
That's why you brought me. Some of us use OBR graphics. We're all these fine people on YouTube. Okay, all right. And a lot of it is kind of half ad lib too. Like, if you're reading the script,
hold on, I gotta exit out of this.
We have fun with
okay,
this,
where's so. HeathyMoose? Look at that. Oh, hello.
Okay.
All right. We're backstage now.
You stand here. We're standing on this. Come stand on the stage.
Come here.
Come stand on the stage.
Okay. So we're standing on the counter, and we're back. Oh, we're
hello.
Now we're on the stage. All
right, bye.
Who was that?
Anyway, over here is all the props.
Oh, where am I? Welcome
to the stage!
Oh, there you are.
You're not done yet. Okay, these are our props.
I don't know if it's good for you to have a gun, HeathyMoose.
I want it. It's mine. I'm going to save this for later. Why can't I throw it? Anyway, the phone is my favorite because it sounds like a bell.
Oh, it's got a bell in it, huh?
When it rings.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And let's see, it's
oh jeez. Where'd that even go?
I don't know, who knows?
Oh, what do you think of this thing, HeathyMoose? What do you think of this?
This thing is giving me flashbacks.
You just hit someone else!
You just hit somebody with it!
You hit someone else!
I got yelled at when I messed with that. Dealing out concussions since 2017.
I don't want to deal with that. That thing's a mess.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, I don't know what else to show you.
Okay. I guess that's it. Thank you for showing us around the backstage, HeathyMoose.
Yeah.
All right, YouTube. I think that's all we've got. Thank you for tuning in. If you did, in fact, tune in. If you didn't, how did you get here?
Don't change it. Don't change it.
Of course.
Oh, HeathyMoose meet and greet. See, this is why you gotta come and see the show live. You know. You get a picture with HeathyMoose.
Scary. I'm scared of it.
All right. Well, thanks so much for showing up. I hope y'all have a good night and happy holidays and all that.
I love it.
Goodbye.
Wait. Okay. Okay, bye.